Saan tayo mag-merienda?
Gutom ako eh.
Oo, kanina pa tayo dito.
I'm so tayo hungry.
Anyway, related dyan ang ating topic, no? Yung kain.
Ay, hindi ko nakita. I didn't see that.
So, actually kasi may a couple of people na nagtanong sa akin, ano ba raw yung feeder fund?
Ah, feeder fund!
Oo.
Feeder fund.
Kasi nakikita nila eh. Ano ba raw yun? Ano ba daw? Kasi, ang alam nila usually, equity fund, fixed income fund,
index fund,
index fund, balance fund. Eh, ano daw yung feeder fund?
Pinapakain ka.
Oo. Ini-invest sa mga
pakain.
At
mga feeds.
Oo, ini-invest sa feeds ba ang pera sa feeder fund. Ayun, sige, sagutin natin yung question na yun. Ano ba ang feeder fund?
Feeder fund is a fund na nag-i-invest sa isang fund.
Okay.
Okay.
Fund kasi, within a fund, parang inception na.
Oo, it's an inception of funds. For example, right now kasi diba, the usual, tawag namin yan is plain vanilla. Mga normal funds, diba? Stock fund, balance fund, you know, bond fund, nag-i-invest sila into securities or stocks.
Kunwari, so, for equity fund.
Equity fund. Makikita mo sa loob nun is SM, BPI.
Yung mga stock market.
Stock
kasi
mismo.
Equity fund siya.
Pag equity fund. Yung kumbaga yung mga companies pag equity fund. Pag bonds naman, makikita mo yung mga individual bonds sa loob.
So may corporate bonds ng Ayala, corporate bonds ng
RTD,
San Miguel, or government bonds. Basta puro bonds yung nandoon.
Yan. So kumbaga, when you look into a fund, may kita mo kung saan naka-invest. Okay? Individual issues or securities. Ang feeder fund, on the other hand, pag nag-invest ka sa fund na yon, ang laman ng fund nun ay isang fund.
Okay.
Like for example, may isang fund sa market na alam ko na nag-feed into a BlackRock fund.
Alright.
Na BlackRock Global Fund, for example.
Alright.
So kunwari, if I invest kunwari into this fund, sabihin na natin Fund X. Okay. If I invest into Fund X, yung laman ng Fund X na yon is a BlackRock Global Fund. Isa lang ang laman niya.
Bakit hindi na lang dumiretso doon?
Kasi hindi ka na maka-invest diretso sa BlackRock eh. Pag ordinary
kasi it's a
offshore
foreign yun, offshore.
Wala silang office dito.
Pero you're in the Philippines, gusto mong mag-invest doon. Hahanap ka ngayon ng local na feeder fund.
Na nag-i-invest doon. So, kumbaga nakikibakas ka, nakikisakay ka.
Pero possible rin ba na dalawa, tatlo yung funds na in-invest ng isang feeder fund?
Hindi, isa lang.
Usually, isa lang.
Pag dalawa or pag marami ng laman sa loob, fund of funds na yon.
May fund of funds. So
may ganun ba?
That's another type of...
More funds. May ganun, fund of funds.
So, pag sinabi mong feeder fund,
Isa lang.
Pero kumbaga, pag marami na sila,
fund of funds
ang tawag.
So kung magay feeder fund, parang ayun lang, ganun.
So, bakit ka mag-i-invest sa isang feeder fund?
Primarily because you don't have access to those funds. Like for example, may mga feeder fund na nag-i-invest in BlackRock, Templeton, mga ganyan na mga, one of the, actually the largest asset management companies or investment companies
sa
the world.
Buong mundo. And
so,
wala tayong access sa kanila dito sa Pilipinas.
At saka yung mga feeder funds na yan, yung iba, minimum 5,000 pesos. Eh, pag mag-invest ka sa BlackRock, wala. Hindi ka maka-invest ng 5,000 pesos.
Tama. So, it gives you accessibility
yes.
to this international. So, even saka, if you're based abroad, di ba? At may access sa kanila, kung ang minimum starting investment nila ay $100,000.
O wala.
Hindi ka makaka-invest. Pero, of course, you want to, make money through them, no? So,
yes.
That's when the feeder funds come into,
So, kumbaga, para, kunwari, you want some global exposure or exposure in emerging markets or Asian market or technology sector, tapos, walang ganung fund dito and those funds are just...
So, paano malalaman, ano ba yung, may listahan ba ng mga feeder fund in the Philippines?
You can go to uitf.com.ph and you see there the different UITFs. But, you can Google naman mga feeder funds. I know some institutions na nag-offer ng feeder funds.
So, available siya sa mga mutual fund companies, tsaka sa
commercial
banks din.
Ang alam ko lang are from asset management companies and
asset management companies.
Universal Bank.
Ah, okay. So sa mga universal banks and asset management companies.
Yung nag-offer kasi very
usually meron silang feeder fund.
Just ask for the feeder fund. So it's good for diversification. For example, kung medyo malaki na 'yung portfolio mo and you know, you wanna test the waters internationally, have some international or you know, Asian or regional or
yeah, South American
favor, ano, ganyan. You can go for the feeder fund.
All right.
Kung medyo ano ka na sa Philippine.
Medyo savvy na sila sa
gusto kong global exposure.
Yeah, at saka sabihin natin na medyo okay, actually okay na yung investments niya in the country. Pero meron pa siyang extra and you want to test kung okay rin ba yung kita sa mga
or diversification
abroad.
Also.
Yeah, or for diba? Diversification.
Kasi isipin mo if all of your investments are in the Philippines, then you are subject to country risk.
Country risk.
Diba? Country risk yun. So, to diversify away country risk, and this is risk management already, portfolio management, invest ka abroad,
sa
Asia, global.
Ibang economies.
Oo, para at least, kunwari, whatever, mag-tank ang Philippine market, eh, may global ka, may Asian ka, may emerging market ka.
May Japan, mayroon kang South America.
Hindi affected, diba? Then, your money there is good. So, it's good for diversification also.
Alright. So, I hope may natutunan kayo sa ating discussion today.
Feeder fund.
Alright. So, if you have questions or mga topic suggestions that you want us to do an episode for, then just write it at the comment section or email us at admin@webarki.com. So, if you like this video, then
thumbs up.
Give it a thumbs up. Share it to your friends. And, of course, please remember to subscribe to our channel. Alright?
Remember to subscribe.
So, that's it. And see you again next week. Bye-bye.